Phil, we are in the first quarter, and there is this anticipation of rate cuts this year. But from your vantage point, when you take a look at the indicators when it comes to Canada's real estate, what are they telling you? What are you seeing when it comes to listings, to showings? What does that look like?
So we track things such as appointments, listing rates that happen well before, call it 90 to 100 days before transactions, the actual sales. And we began to see them lift in the middle of November. We've just gotten actual transaction data from the Canadian Real Estate Association that shows month over month, we had an 8% rise in the number of homes trading hands in December. And in the first 2 weeks of January, we know those leading indicators are up as well. So this all leads us to believe that we have turned a corner in terms of the number of homes trading hand in the country, and more people are entering the market.
Let's talk about, I guess, that expectation that rate cuts are going to spur the market. Does that typically go hand in hand? What is the expectation? How do you see it?
So people typically purchase homes not based on their sticker price, but on the monthly carrying costs, their mortgage payment, call it rent equivalency. So when interest rates go up, it makes homes on a cash flow basis more expensive. And when they come down, it makes them more affordable. So typically, rising rates mean falling sales. But just like equity markets, there's some anticipation built into real estate markets. So people tend to act before things actually occur on the anticipation that that's the way the economic world will unfold.
Phil, you had mentioned the CREA numbers that came out that talked about what sales had looked like in December. And I guess overall, the picture for 2023 seemed to suggest that these were the lowest sales in, I guess, more than a decade. What is the expectation for sales this year? The expectation, I guess, for home prices. Do you think we'll see those double-digit increases?
So we believe that we'll see the market bottoming out. It probably bottomed out in December, and we just haven't gotten to those two data points that make a line yet. But we think that the first quarter will be, in hindsight, the bottom of the market correction that started 21 months ago, and that both volume and prices will start to inch up. I think volume will be, it will precede and prices will follow. That's typically what happens. And so think of the first quarter as prices basically flat in our modeling, up half a percentage point by the end of the first quarter. By the end of the year, and included in there right at mid-year in our modeling, is the first modest interest rate cut from the Bank of Canada. We believe nationally home prices will be up 5.5%.
When you take a look at that picture across the country, is that 5.5% right across the board, or is that different coast to coast?
Very different. A good question. But the interesting thing is that, like, if you look at the fourth quarter numbers in the Royal Lepage House Price Survey, 80% of markets saw a slip in home prices in the fourth quarter of 2023. Whereas when we're looking at markets in 2024, we see all markets rising in value, ranging from, say, 3% in Regina or Vancouver to 8% in Calgary, with 5.5 nationally. The only other region we see being higher than that 5.5 is the Greater Toronto Area, where we see prices up at 6%, so just above the national number.
You had mentioned volume earlier, and we're still short on housing. We're experiencing population growth here in Canada. There are conversations that perhaps we can't meet those numbers or what's needed. And when you take a look at those housing starts, do we really have the skilled labor force needed to get those starts off the ground? How do you look at all of those elements in this housing equation?
Well, the first thing, and sadly, I say this sadly, there is no way that public policy, whether it's around hiring skilled labor or cutting some of the red tape and costs, that's slowing the rate at which we add housing to our housing supply. There's no way that it can meet the demand. We're behind, and each year we're getting farther behind. A million new Canadian immigrants were added to the housing need in 2023. And on top of that, we have a record number of non-permanent residents, people here on temporary work permits, like nurses, programmers, and foreign students who, you know, attend our great institutions. And even though they're probably in rental accommodation, it's still housing. And so, unfortunately, as we look ahead at the rest of the decade, the reality is that home prices will rise at an uncomfortably high level, simply because household formation has far outpaced the rate at which we're building homes. That doesn't mean we should take our eye off the ball. It doesn't mean that we shouldn't try to narrow the gap, because every effort, every bit of housing that we put into circulation is going to take the edge off those uncomfortably high home price or rent price increases.